Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Final Fantasy VII. So, I did a little bit of grinding off screen, not a whole lot. As you can see, Cloud is at now level 25, Aerith at level 24. I used their limit breaks a little bit, but not enough to get any new limit levels. And I think the only materia that actually leveled up was... Oh, it was Earth, which is now... Oh my god, Earth, which is now level 2. And I put Transform in its place just so that we can get some XP from it. Really, I just wanted to get a little bit more money because we were going to cut it real close if I left it there. I believe before I started grinding, we had just a little under 30,000. And now we have 42,000. You'll see why in a second. Yeah, what's going on? What are they all like on about back there? Yeah, we gathered. Wait, yeah, used to? Oh. Buried. What? I'm sure it's not your fault. Oh, flashback time. Okay, coal mining. Respectable. Dusty and poor, but it's calm. Yeah, it looks pretty calm. Oh, okay. Who mentioned make a reactor? Oh. Oh, I see. So they're getting paid to put in a reactor. Yeah. Guarantee your livelihood, huh? You had a wife? Why not? Why is it so important to keep the coal mines? Okay, core reactor built and completed. What? They just set fire? Why? This part doesn't make any sense to me. I don't quite understand why they would burn down the town after they made the reactor. Like, is there any reason to burn down the town? Yeah, why? Explosion at a reactor. Oh. I see. Oh, yeah. Lost your wife there, too. Alright, well, we're gonna get on the ropeway and go to the Gold Saucer now. Thanks for telling us your story, Barrett. Yep. That's really depressing. Yeah, everyone's kind of speechless. Yuffie! You're not going! No, you're not allowed. Everyone on the big blue tram. Such an interesting idea, this like cable rope car, but it also has jets and turbines for some reason. And here we are, coming to this grand, grand place. The Gold Saucer. It honestly looks pretty cool. Like, it's enormous, though not on the inside. It's actually pretty small on the inside, all things considered. Now, there is a part of this episode which will be a pain in the ass. And I'm hoping I can do it relatively quickly and simply, and we'll just go through it once, and that'll be that. Because on your first trip to the Gold Saucer, there is not a lot that you can do. But there is one specific thing that I want to get. All right. Yep, to the Gold Saucer, this big chocobo chicken thing. Oh, we have to buy a ticket. All right, well, how much is the ticket? Oh my god, it's so expensive. We're just going to pay the lifetime pass. Yeah. Must pay with GP, money that only is at Gold Saucer. Can redeemed at Wonder Square and at the Chocobo races. GP limit is 10,000. And there we go. So the only reason that the only reason why I did that is because it's technically a key item, the unlimited pass. And also, I don't remember if you get to keep GP past certain stuff. Like, if you can keep it when you leave. And we're going to do a couple things that which is going to get us GP here. So, of course, we're going to, you know, get that. What do you say, Barrett? Cheer up. Yeah, it's a little harsh. Yeah, Barrett's pretty angry. And he goes to the Wonder Square. You think? Doing better, huh? Okay, well. Yeah, we can go together. And, let's take... Yeah, so you can basically choose your party. Take whoever you want. We're gonna take Tifa and Aerith. Why not? Oh, you can only take one person? All right, well, in that case, let's take Tifa. She's the best. Okay, let's go to the Ghost Square first. There's a couple things we gotta do. Mostly because I always forget to do it, so I'd rather do it now and get it out of the way. This is basically just an inn. Oh, yeah, the Ghost Hotel. But we don't have a reservation. In fact, all we really want to do is read this flyer. Turtle Paradise 3. I love how there's an advertisement that shits on the Gold Saucer inside of the Gold Saucer. Kind of amazing. Okay. And now we're going to go to the Speed Square. Oh boy. Oh, that's right. We can meet Dio. Hey, man. Boy. I'm not a... Well, I mean, we are a boy, I guess. Okay. Yeah, please stop calling me boy. Oh. What... Why are you in Speedos? Black material? What is it? A boy our age. What? Uh-oh. Where'd he go? What do you mean you have no idea? Stop by the battle arena. Well, we should probably stop by the battle arena then, you know? That's interesting. Hey, Johnny! Yep, Johnny's just here. Well, actually, I don't even know if that's actually Johnny. Is this Johnny? 5,000 points. Oh my god. Finally got a prize. Yeah, and that'll be us in a minute. What is the battle square? Oh, right, it's under renovations right now, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, so we can't even see anything. All right, before we go to the Wonder Square and go after Barret... Actually, I may need to go there first. Let's see if we can do this. And I'll cry, because it's so difficult. Here are the rules. Not interested. 10 GP, okay. So we need to go get some GP first, The only way to do that is to go to the Wonder Square, where we can earn GP by doing little games. What? What the hell are you? Wait, didn't we see you in Midgar? Read your fortune. Oh no. I don't like fortune tellers. Fortune telling machine? Wait. What does he have? Alright. Why does he have a name picking screen? Only the future, huh? Find missing things, missing people. Uh-huh. Where's Sephiroth? And he does a little dance. Well, I mean, if he's really good at it, maybe he will tell us where Sephiroth is. Ordinary luck, it will be an active fortune. Give in to the good of will of others, and something big will happen after summer. What? That doesn't make any sense. It's not at all related to our question. Be careful of forgetfulness. Your lucky color is blue? What? Quick dance this time. What? What you will pursue will be yours, but you will lose something dear. Well, that's pretty ominous. Uh-huh. What? What do you mean? It's gonna bug you. What? No. Excuse me? That's not... Oh, okay, he just went inside of her body. Yeah, that happens. So now we get Kate Sith. He's just a character. He's got silver armlet, which is better than our carbon bangles. We can give him stuff if we want. He also comes equipped with the manipulate... I guess I didn't need to buy that. He also comes with manipulate, which is very important because it's the only way to actually get certain enemy skill material. But we don't really have to worry about that right now. Let's go into the Wonder Square. Have a good time. Okay. Oh, you know, I never thought about this before, but like I could absolutely turbo this game and do the arm wrestling. Wow. I never thought about that. Maybe. I really want to do this one thing back here first. So there's a lot of different games. You can't... I think we can play G-Bike right now. Yeah, it costs gil to use. It's basically the thing that we did in Midgar. There's a submarine game that's out of order and a snowboarding game that's out of order. We can do those later. I believe there's a fortune teller here, which is absolutely useless. And then this over here. Don't worry about me. Go ahead and play. All right, we'll play this. One game, 100 gil. Okay. Beep, boop, 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 boop. This is Mog's house. It's in Mog Forest on Mount Mog. Beginning of another day in the life of Mog. This year, Mog is a... What? Is it... Is... Pippo... Po... What? Did I never read that properly the first time? Okay, well, whatever. He's at that age when he should be looking for a mate. Oh. He needs to learn how to fly. Well, yeah, I mean, if that's all that he needs. Let's see. I gotta pull up the proper thing so that I know what I'm doing. Where is it? Because I don't want to do this wrong. Snow game, submarine game. Wait, what? Where the hell is the Mog House game? Here we go, Mog House. Mog trains hard every day, still can't seem to get off the ground. Oh, he just hits the ground right away, huh? Okay. Help him learn to fly by pushing OK and feeding him his favorite nut. Don't overfeed him. He won't be able to fly if he's too fat. Alright, we'll give him a nut. Go eat it, you dick. He's gonna eat the nut. Oh, he's still hungry. I'll have another one. There's two. There's a third nut. Aw. He must be so hungry. A fourth nut. He's just eating nuts. All of the nuts. And a fifth nut. And he's happy. And then you don't press OK. You just let the game go. Right? I think you just wait. Are we good? Okay, go. Okay. So you give him five nuts. He's going to take another shot at it. How do you learn to fly? Wow, that was super easy. I wish I could do that. Get me a coconut. Cool little mushroom house. He goes back inside. And he's gonna sleep off the day. He learned how to fly. That's all he's gotta do. Alright. Oh. What's this? I didn't even know that was what's in the text box. A female mog. She knocks. She comes a knocking. Oh. Yeah. He's excited. She's like clipping through that mushroom. Yeah, let's give him a few coconuts. Help him out there. Oh, he needs more. One more. That's two. I hate that you have to wait through this animation. Okay, three is enough. Yeah, that's a good idea not to overeat in front of the lady. You don't want to show yourself gorging on anything after all. That would be real, just not great. Are we good? Good, Mog. There we go. Decided to take another shot at it. And up he goes and flies around. He did it. Wow. Well, we helped him fly. Yeah. Good job, Mog. She fell for him. Okay. Sometime later. Oh, look at that. Mag. Okay. Oh, wow. Okay. They had a lot of children, I guess. Yeah, no worries there. And he waves away to us. Okay, well, you don't get anything for it. But if you turn around to this guy, he's impressed because he was watching us. It's like a Let's Play. And it gives us 30 GP. So that's the easiest way to get like a good bit of GP early. You could do the G-Bike. It's not horrible, and you will get some GP, it's just expensive. I do want to show off two of the things. I'm not great at this. Also, If you talk to her, you can exchange your GP for prizes. You can get a gold ticket with 300 GP, which I could have just done that, to be perfectly honest, but I think it's more expensive to do it this way. And then a mystery gift at 500. Now, I'm horrible at this. Hold down okay to gain strength, release okay to shoot. Alright. You gotta, like, do it, like... Yeah. I'm gonna try it one more time. You gotta, like, release it right when it reaches the top. It's so difficult. Hold on. How much money do we have? Because I don't want to waste all of our money. Okay, I can do it a few more times. So, if you get really, really good at this, you can make a good bit of GP off of it. The other thing is this arm wrestling thing, which is actually rigged. You're not supposed to be able to beat it. However, I'm going to cheat real quick. I'm going to go set up a turbo function for my controller. So I'll be right back. Okay, so we have made a turbo set. So let me show you what happens when you turn on turbo and do the sumo wrestler. Now, because it keeps doing okay consecutively, we're just going to beat the sumo wrestler immediately. And you get GP for that. Yeah, it's as simple as that. If you have turbo, it's super easy. Oh, I am real curious. How many was that? That's 1 GP. Now, the other thing you can do is you can try the wrestler. Still turn on turbo, and I believe you get 2 GP for beating him. Yep, 2 GP. So for 100 gil, 2 GP, not a bad conversion rate, to be honest. You can keep doing that and get a whole bunch. At 100 each, for 100 for 2 GP, I do believe there's no way I have enough money to get that 500 GP thing, but that's fine because, you know, I just wanted to show that off. Let me show it off real quick without turbo. I'll just show you, like, what a regular person is able to do. And I'm, like, fairly okay at tapping buttons. Like, look at this. It's ridiculous. It's so difficult. Yeah. Anyways, we're all done here for now. Again, I might go back and, like, just, you know, turbo through some GP, but it's not super needed. Anyways, we have GP now, so we're going to go back to the speed square. And once we're here, we've got GP, right? Oh, would turbo work here too? Well, that does have me curious a little bit. I want to try it once myself. We're going to pay. We're going to go on the ride. I don't remember the buttons. Is it square or okay? Oh my god, that's amazing! You can turbo it! Alright, I'm just gonna leave it on turbo. Because this is actually better. Oh, but it's so hard to control. So, there is a little trick to this. And it doesn't work on the PS1 version, unfortunately. Alright, so there should be things coming up soon. Oh, it's so difficult on the PC version. But thankfully, we don't need to worry about anything ridiculously. We just need to be ready for one thing in particular. Alright, so there's something that basically shows up for like all of 1 second. And we need to hit it. I think it's coming up right after balloons, I believe. And hopefully I hit it. Because if I don't, this is going to be bad. Well, I got a few points off of that wheel. Oh my lord. Yeah, you can shoot these stars. Get yourself a few points. But what we want is right after the balloons. Well, it's coming up soon, actually. Wow. I'm, like, not getting anything here. Oh, wow. Actually, that wasn't so horrible. Alright, it's coming up very soon. After these balloons. Alright, it should be like... Oh, I got the big balloon. Look at that. I never get the big balloon. Alright. Like, right over here? Oh, I missed it. No, I missed it. It's only there for a second. So the propeller, like the wheel on the back of the Zeppelin is very particular. But if you can hit it, you get good stuff from it. Oh, my dear Lord. You get a lot of points from hitting that thing. But unfortunately, I did not. So this is a wash. Well, not entirely a wash. There's a couple of items we can still get from this, which is not bad. Alright. Come on, are you gonna give me the, Oh, wow, we killed that thing. Alright, cool. Well, we got over 3,000, so that's not horrible. Oh, I got one of the lights. Cool. Well, we got 3,500. It's not great. But that's okay. What did I win? Ah, 135th soldier? Oh, that's annoying. Oh, no. Whoa. Wall of Fame, yeah. So that's our high score. You'll receive a prize if you get more than 3,000 points. So we just barely got a prize. I'm going to try this one more time, and I'm going to skip ahead because I may have to go back to the Wonder Square and get more GP. So hopefully I don't have to do this too many times, but hopefully I'm going to come back to this when I get that propeller and do it right. It's really important that we do that. All right. Well, there we go. I got it. Oh my dear Lord, hitting that propeller really does work. It gets you a stupid amount of points. It did take me a lot of tries to do it. But, wow. Still not patched. This is 2019. So, awesome. I just can't believe that I did it. That makes me wonder what the theoretical maximum is. I mean, it's hard to actually tell how many points the Zeppelin actually gets you, to be perfectly honest. I think you could safely probably get to like 32,000. Well, awesome. Cool. And then if you hold down to the left, oh, I don't know why I didn't get it. Sometimes I don't get it. You can get the light there. All right, well. We'll have to do that another time later for something else. But if you do this properly, yeah, 29,000 points. And you get the umbrella, which is something that a lot of people don't know about because this is a ridiculous area of the game. But the umbrella is a weapon for Aerith. We'll get to that. Anyways, let me real quick, 1, 2, 3. There we go. And now we can continue on with the game. So, after you're done with everything in the Gold Saucer and you have Kate Sith in your party, head over to the Battle Square. Actually, real quick. If I de-equip that, is the Silver Armlet better? Oh, it is better. You know what? Yeah, I'm giving Silver Armlet to Cloud, because he's always in the party. And then we can give you the Manipulate Materia. Fantastic. And we head over to the Battle Square. Uh-oh. That music never spells anything good. Oh, he died. That's really not good, actually. Dead. D-E dead. And Cloud just runs up into the battle arena. Well, because we've heard Sephiroth was around here, and he was looking at Dio's collection. He said to come over to the battle arena. Oh boy. It's a lot of people dead. Oh, they're all shot? Oh no. Oh no. This is bad, man. This is real bad. What? Oh, it's the bikini guy. Or Speedo guy. No, obviously we didn't. None of us have guns. What? What? Why would you run? Kid Sith, why? Why would you do that? Oh, Lord. Kid Sith, I hate you. I really do. There's just an enormous amount of hate in me. Oh, we're not gonna fight those things? Okay. The gate to heaven? Or gateway to heaven? Well, that doesn't sound too bad. Oh, God. He thinks we did it. This is all sorts of bad. What? 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 Oh. Well, that doesn't look nice. Yeah, where are we? A desert prison. What? I don't want to be in a desert prison. That's horrible. Natural prison in the middle of the desert? Oh, good. Once you get in, you never get out. That's, one special exception. I wonder what that is. Barret's down here, too! Oh, no. Hey, Barret. Oh, there's another dead guy. This is bad. What do you mean something you have to deal with? There's just a bunch of dead bodies! Yeah, it is pretty dangerous. Oh boy. Let's go follow him. Alright. Oops, I did not mean to zone out there. Yeah, these guys, they chase after you. I don't think they actually do anything if they catch up to you. They just chase you. I don't know, I've never actually stuck around long enough to know. I mean, you didn't tell us not to come into this house. Are you gonna shoot us? All right, we're impervious to bullets. Of course. Yeah. Oh. Okay. I mean, we're involved now, so, you know. Oh! They're all here. Can't let you get involved. Blah, 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 blah. What's happening here? Yeah, did you kill a bunch of people, Barret? Did you? Another man that got a gun grafted into his arms? What? Oh. So this is when the city's being burned down. I like that Barret used to have a white shirt. Just like an actual white shirt. Ooh, that's tough to see. I don't know, man. It doesn't look good. Oh, okay. He's having seizure. Oh, okay. Someone get some help for him. Oh, okay. And now he's humping the ground. It's okay. You don't... Oh, I don't know what's happening there. It's really hard to know. Oh! No, old guy! Oh, shit. They fucking killed the old guy. Wow. Wow, Barret can dance. Jeez, man. Yeah, wow, they got... Did you just... punch the dude off? And now here's the best scene in the game. As we get to watch Scarlet shoot from her fists. I laugh at it every time.
Oh, and that's why Barrett had to get a new arm.
Oh, that sound effect wasn't there before.
Another man who got the same operation. Oh, that was definitely dying.
Join us? More party members?
Oh, okay.
You gotta go alone. No, you don't. That's not happening. Cloud's the leader here. I can't let you do it. Yeah, we're coming with you.
Yep. Easy to understand you, Barrett.
And you gotta pick someone, so we're gonna go with Aerith.
Actually, what I need to do real quick is get Red's... Or actually, who do we have? We had Yuffie. Is your materia still on you?
It is. Anyways, the weapon we have for her is the umbrella.
It has no slots.
But look at that attack.
Lord, just to give you an idea, the Force Stealer, Cloud's best weapon so far, does 36, and Earth does 58.
I'm sorry, I laugh every time because it's always funny. And we're gonna give you an all materia. And Shiva, sure. Why not?
Oh boy, we gotta equip Barrett too. Also, let's give him the new weapon. So, that'll lower his attack. You know what? I think I'm just going to keep the atomic scissors on him for now.
Oop, I did not mean to do that. And, you know, we're going to give him the silver armlet. And then, deck vest. We can give you the protect vest. Okay, cool.
And then you are going to get some materia, my friend. Let's give you the restore. I'll give you an all. Steel's kind of useless. We've got Quake too. That could be pretty interesting. But actually, we don't really want to lower his attack that much. Manipulate's interesting. This is just a weird thing. You know what? I'll set him properly when we actually get up there. And for now, I'm just gonna give him a bunch of stuff. Poison. We wanna get manipulate up there. And then I guess we'll level up steel. Actually, what we really have to do, real quick. Yeah. Gotta get Yuffie back. And let's take off her materia. Well, you know what? I'm gonna take off that too. There we go. Fantastic. That's the party I want. Cover, long range, HP plus. So we're gonna take long range out. We're gonna put Ifrit on us. HP plus is not a bad thing to have, so. Cover's also not a bad thing to have. Put revive on us. And we'll give you cover, we'll give you long range. And that way, Barrett can stay in the back row. There's a reason for all of this. For all this insanity. Trust me. Okay, I think we're good to go. I know, usually we load up Aerith with a whole bunch of materia. Not what we're going to be doing here. Alright. So that chest is empty. I don't think that there's anything else on this screen other than those, like, weirdos. There are, however, enemies here, and I want to show you how Aerith gets down. So she has her nice pretty parasol, and she's just gonna beat the ever-loving hell out of people with it now. Look at that, it did 200-some damage. Wow, that, okay. That's amazing. And Blade Beam. I don't know if any of you have actually seen Blade Beam yet. Does a ton of damage. Pretty great. Wow, that hurt us a lot, actually. So even though Aerith has like this super amazing attack now, it's still just basically on par with everyone else's. So unfortunately, we're not going to get much out of it just yet. But it is something that we need for the future. And since right now it's Barret's show, we're going to give her the wizard's... Hey, you know, we'll stick with the umbrella for now. We'll just have her be a walking, attacking mage. Pay respects to Mr. Coates. Who's that? I mean, I'd like to go up. To win a chocobo race. Okay, not as easy as we think. Got the boss's permission. Who's the boss? I have a feeling we know who the boss is. Alright, then we definitely have to go see Dine. Oh yeah, and these guys will just chase you. All of them. They're annoying. Oh, okay, cool. Then we've seen the two enemies that are basically here. Let me get rid of this target thing. It's been annoying us. Who are you attacking? Oh, healed us all. Thank you. It has a weird thing. A weird AI. What did you get? Did you get a Titan Bangle? Excuse me? We need to kill this guy real quick. There we go. He took my Titan Bangle? What a dick. Alright, so those are the two basic enemies you're gonna see around here in the Coral Prison. It's the muggy guys. I don't remember their names. And the spinning face things. There are other enemies that we can find here. And one in particular. I wanna do it now? I guess I should. Alright, but before we go do that, I mean, we'll see if I find that enemy. It's actually kind of a rare spawn. Oh, wait. I thought there was an item down here. Never mind. It's all empty. There's no items down in Coral Prison. It's a prison. What did you expect? So, let's real quick try and find this one enemy. I don't know whether it's worth it or not. But if you go right here, you'll find this desert screen. By the way, if you keep going right, you'll eventually, like, enact a scene that'll transport you back to the prison. You know, I actually wonder if I can get it. Like, it's actually really hard to get this scene. You just keep walking into the desert. Wait, what? That little rock in the middle actually has some, like, something on it? You can run into it? Oh god! The worm. I forgot about this thing. It hurts a little bit. Well, it's not a bad thing to get Barret's Limit Break, actually. We got Earthquake 2. So we could show off Quake 2 for once. You know, wow, you didn't even see it. Wow, we healed it. Oh boy. What limit break do you have? You actually have the new good limit break. Let's not waste that. Why do you have so much health? Poison it. Oh, okay, you killed it. All right. I'm not going to lie. It's kind of a bad idea to come out here into the desert. So I'm just going to head back because I don't know why I did that. That was dumb. That was really dumb. I'm going to have to go back 3 screens. That's annoying. I don't know why I did this. Such a dumb idea. But yeah, if you keep going up, there will be a little carriage that brings you back to the prison, essentially. Oh no. Oh, that's bad. I think I got stuck in the loop. Okay, well, we're officially stuck in the loop, so the best way out of this is actually just to change screens until the carriage comes along. So we do this. Man, I can't believe I got stuck. Oh, I'm an idiot. We probably will get into a few battles, but let me just skip ahead to when the carriage comes. There it is. That didn't take too long. Oh, at least you guys got to see the scene. Want a ride? Yeah, I do. Okay, so there's the one way to do it. Oh my god, is that Joe? Huh. Alright, you guys don't know who Joe is yet. You will. Alright, I didn't expect him. Alright, and we get dropped off here in the desert. Cool. Fantastic. Go over. And we can talk to this guy. Boss was really in a bad mood. Oh, I think we're on the right trail. The boss is this way at the very least. And you get to this screen. And we just go up. Through all the wreckage. Alright. Let's make sure we're all equipped and ready to go. Long range, cover. The only reason I put cover on here is because it gives them the vitality plus 1. So it's just like a little bit extra, you know, of that. One thing I am going to do is we're going to give them HP plus as well. So you don't need poison. I would rather you have the extra HP. And you can tell I'm only doing this for Barrett. This is one of the few times I'm going to use an ether in the game. Because I'd rather him have some HP as well. Or MP, rather. Oh boy, he said he has to do this alone. There's Dine. Just shooting off into the void, weirdly. I mean, I guess that's not super healthy. A voice you'll never forget. I don't think he wants to talk to us, though. Uh-oh. Hear whose voice? Eleanor's voice. Oh. Okay. Yeah, you should listen to Eleanor. Seems like a very sensible lady. In your head. Yeah, why are you here? Oh boy, I think Dine just went insane, huh? Yeah. Uh-huh. I mean, a Y would be nice. Oh, okay. You are crazy. It's not really a city. You know, it's a prison. Again, it's not a city. You should probably stop shooting Barrett. Marlene's alive. Oh, that got his attention. Oh, I don't think he cares. Yeah? Yeah, she is. What? Why? Oh, no. He's absolutely insane. Yeah. So Dine just loses it. And what I want to do real quick. Oh, okay. Oh, damn it. I gave him the wrong material. All right, whatever. I guess we'll quake to him because it probably does more damage than Barret's attack. Let's see how much this does. 264? Actually? Barret's attack may be just as good. Nope, not at all. Barret's attack is a lot quicker. Does not a lot of damage, actually. Wow, okay. Maybe, I don't know, maybe I just... Wow, his face is so ugly in the Steam version. Okay. The needle gun, honestly. Oh, you know, actually, the needle gun does slightly less damage than S-Mine. Not by a lot. He is very quick. In a minute here. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna do it now. Yep. Oh, I knew he was gonna use that soon. Hopefully it doesn't kill him in one hit. Oh, only 69 damage? Alright, that's fine. And back to full health for Barret. Yeah. That's why I gave him the restore material. Then we're just gonna beat the shit out of him. Oh! And we got our limit break, I believe. Damn it, Don, you're so quick! That's absolutely absurd that it gets multiple turns before a limit break goes off. This might finish off Don. He's not really that difficult. There's a Barret's nice level 2 limit break. Grenade bomb. Oh, I think that was the end of the fight. Yep. He gives off one final Molotov cocktail, which isn't a Molotov cocktail at all. It's just him shooting a whole bunch. So, you know. Barret goes up a level and we get another silver armlet. Uh-oh. He's really hurt. That's not good. Probably when you started killing people. You probably went wrong there. You're a fucking idiot, Dine. Oof. You have killed a lot of people for absolutely no reason. Although, I do have questions. Like, where was Dine, like, the past 5 years? Or whatever. Yep, already 4. You know, there's something I've never done. I have never gone back to Calm to talk to Marlene. Oh, I guess she's not there yet. Okay. She's still in Midgard. Marlene is in Midgard. Yeah. Okay, never mind. And Dine just backflips off the edge. What a dummy. Poor Barret. Not a good time. Not a good time. Hello, dude. Yeah. Yeah, we fucking killed Dine. We're going up. Yeah, I doubt that. It's still a prison. Yeah, you don't know anything, buddy. Now, I'm going to keep going just because there's, like, no save point for a while, so this episode may go a little long, but I don't know. Mistaken. Yeah, the Chocobo race, right. All right, so let's go. One racer. Even if you threaten me. All right, well. Barret's like, Cloud, you go. Alright, we gotta win a chocobo race. Yeah, I guess so. A manager. Who? Esther. Who is this? Why do you want to be our manager? That was pretty rude. Nice to meet you too, I guess. She has really big feet. Oh no, they just look like really weird and pointy. Because everyone else has like big boots. Talk to Dio directly. Many different types of chocobo jockeys. Yeah? Uh-huh. How? Okay. I don't remember. I don't know what assist. Oh, that's select. Control the chocobo yourself. Hard to make the chocobo run the way you want it to. If the chocobo doesn't like you, you won't listen. Okay. Switch to speed up and cancel to slow down. So I think it's square and X. Right. Okay is boost. All right. All right, start to end the race. Got it. And welcome to the Chocobo Racing Place. There's just a bunch of people here. Yeah, we're new. There's Joe. I'm pretty sure that's the dude that picked us up in the middle of the desert. What's up, Joe? Chocobo jockeys. Oh, boy. When we're doing the chocobo stuff later, Joe is going to be an asshole. Yeah, I think we're made again too, Joe. And I'm going to hate your goddamn guts. See you later, man. And over in the corner, there's a Rama material. Make sure you get that. Don't get cocky, kid. Skills are the only thing that matter in the race. It's true, actually. Yep. Everybody's getting ready for the thing, but you can't actually do anything. In fact, this is one of the weirdest times where you can actually just exist outside of the map. Because this black area right here is actually open. You can't actually do anything. You just gotta wait until Esther comes back. I wish you could follow him. Yeah, Esther. Uh-huh. All right, we're registered. Yeah, I think I remember. Hopefully I do well. You have to actually win here. So, thankfully it's pretty easy to win. As long as you travel at the pace where you don't lose that much stamina. Yeah, there we go. Now I'm traveling at a pace where I'm not using any stamina. And you just sort of want to stay in front. The other chocobo jockeys, like, really tend to use up all their stamina, like, real quick. And then boost right at the end. Oh, Lord. We're not going to win. Wow. They really messed me up. All right, well, that's annoying. Okay, I guess I can use a little bit more speed than I thought. All right, start to end the race. Too bad. Oh my God. I hate this so much that you have to wait. You have to wait for all of these guys to clear the screen. Oh, that's cool. Well, okay, I'll count that. If you lose, you get to see this door closed because otherwise this door is always open. That's really cool. I never noticed that before. Usually because I win. But it's been a very long time. Yeah. There's no penalty for losing, by the way. You just have to keep doing this over and over until you win. Which is kind of dumb. Yeah, that guy in first is gonna lose all his speed. Because they're going to slow down. Yep, see? Now he's moving uber slow. I believe if I just stay at the speed, like, no one can catch up to me. Is that how it is? I just got to stay at the speed the whole time? Oh, well, hopefully that's it. It's been a long, long time. Yeah, we're super far ahead. Okay, that's the trick for this first race. This isn't what you want to do for all the races. I'll be totally honest. So if you do this for all the races, you will lose. And then we can just take it fairly leisurely, actually. to the end. They're going to start to do their final sprints in a moment here. But it doesn't matter. Burp. Past the finish line with a exhausted chocobo. You have to wait until second at least finishes before you can end the race. Now you're home free. There we go. Then we got a letter from someone. Dio. Now you earned it. Heard about Dine. Now you won, granting you and your friends a full pardon. Oh, well, yeah, thank you. Oh, a little gift. What's the gift? Oh, we're getting a call. Right, because Cloud has a cell phone. I forgot about that. Dropped off a buggy. Go over deserts and rivers. Yep, that's right. We get a new mode of transportation. What? Toward Ganga. Or Ganaga. I don't know how to pronounce it. Okay, well. Yeah, we'll see you again, Esther, when we get our own people, when we get our own stuff. Anyways, we'll stick with this party. And we're in the buggy! And cross shallow rivers and deserts. You can even enter Costa del Sol and Junon by buggy. That's very, very important, and the game tells us that for a reason. So we're gonna go ahead and save. And next time, we're gonna do exactly that. We're gonna head back over to Junon for a reason. Anyways, actually a couple of reasons. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye!